The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, whose dear Son, on the night before he suffered, instituted the sacrament of his body and blood, mercifully grant that we may receive it thankfully in remembrance of Jesus Christ our Lord, who in these holy mysteries gives us a pledge of eternal life, and who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall mark for you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year for you. Tell the whole congregation of Israel that on the 10th of this month, they are to take a lamb for each family, a lamb for each household. If a household is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join its closest neighbor in obtaining one. The lamb shall be divided in proportion to the number of people who eat of it. This is how you should eat it: your loins girded, your sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand. And you shall eat it hurriedly. It is the Passover of the Lord. For I will pass through the land of Egypt that night, and I will strike down every firstborn in the land of Egypt, both human beings and animals. On all the gods of Egypt, I will execute judgments. I am the Lord. The blood shall be a sign for you on the houses where you live. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and no plague shall destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt. This shall be a day of remembrance for you. You shall celebrate it as a festival to the Lord. Throughout your generations, you shall observe it as a perpetual ordinance." The word of the Lord.
Hinted by How shall we love this heart-strong God who gives us everything, whose ways to us are strange and odd? What can we give or bring? Acceptance of the matchless gift.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Now before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put it in the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I am doing, but later you will understand." And Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." And Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was to betray him. For this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet, had put on his robe, and had returned to the table, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example, that you also should do as I have done to you. Very truly I tell you, servants are not greater than their master, nor are messengers greater than the one who sent them. If you know these things, you are blessed if you do them. Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and as I said to the Jews, so I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Christ.
May I speak in the name of our one holy and triune God.
Amen.
Amen. This is the night when we remember the events that took place at the Last Supper. Jesus washing the feet of his disciples, sharing dinner with them, and then blessing them with a new commandment to love one another. It's a story that we tell, at least in part, every single time that we share in Holy Eucharist together. And yet tonight it all hits a little bit differently. This is the night when we begin in earnest our journey through the Triduum, when we engage the wide range of emotions and sensations that we encounter in these stories, the stories that carry us into the most painful and unjust corners of our shared faith history. Juxtaposition is the character of Maundy Thursday. Loyalty contrasted with betrayal. Glory contrasted with humility. Intimacy contrasted with heartbreak. This night is achingly beautiful. It is hopeful. It is devastating. And Jesus, seeing his own death on the horizon, wraps a fresh towel around his waist and kneels down to tenderly rinse the dusty feet of his dearest friends, his chosen family. And they resist, stunned and confused by this act of humility. And can't you just see them reacting in this moment? No, this is wrong. It's not supposed to be like this. This is not the order of things. This is too strange, too intense. You will not wash my feet. How many times in your own story have you had a similar reaction? Think of when you've been on the receiving end of someone's overwhelming, embarrassing hospitality. When you've been on the receiving end of someone pouring their heart out for you. Think of when you've borne witness to the vulnerability and fragility of another human being. When you've felt uncomfortable. When you've just wanted to say, no, get up, don't do this, be strong, you will never wash my feet. The hymn that was sung just before we read this gospel ends with these four lines. How shall we love this heart-strong God who gives us everything, whose ways to us are strange and odd? What can we give or bring? Acceptance of the matchless gift is gift enough to give. The very act will shake and shift the way we love and live. Acceptance of the gift. To accept the gift of undying love poured out upon us can feel like too much to bear. And we as disciples try all different manners of avoiding it. We reject, we betray, we fall asleep. We deny. But this is the work of Holy Week. This is the work of Easter. And this is the work of the discipleship of our whole lives. The acceptance of the gift. The very act will shake and shift the way we love and live. And so tonight, And as we move through these next few days, I invite you to let your guard down. Let your feet be washed in spite of the confusion and the discomfort. Let yourself be loved fully in spite of all the risk that that entails. Yes, there is heartbreak and injustice ahead. Yes, there is resurrection. Yes, there is new life. And so let us walk together through these next days, wrapped up in the tender, humble, and intimate grace of our God. Our God, whose gentle power binds up the brokenhearted, repairs the breach, rebuilds the ancient ruins, and makes all things new. Accept the gift. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and a joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Lord God Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For our sins he was lifted high upon the cross, that he might draw the whole world to himself, and by his suffering and death he became the source of eternal salvation for all who put their trust in him. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and with archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Gracious Father, in your infinite love you made us for yourself, and when we had fallen subject to sin and became subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks, he shared it with his friends, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, so that sins may be forgiven. Whenever you drink this, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And we celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit, so that they may be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. The gifts of God for the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Let us pray. In union, blessed Jesus, with the faithful throughout the world, and at every altar of your church where your blessed body and blood are offered this day, we long to offer you praise and thanksgiving. We believe that you are truly present in the Holy Sacrament, and since we cannot at this time receive communion, we pray you to come into our hearts. We unite ourselves with you and embrace you with all of our hearts, our souls, and our minds. Let nothing separate us from you. And let us serve you in this life until by your grace we come to your glorious kingdom and unending peace. Amen.
Let us pray. Loving God, we give you thanks for restoring us in your image and nourishing us with spiritual food in the sacrament of Christ's body and blood. Now send us forth, people, forgiven, healed, renewed, that we may proclaim your love to the world and continue in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen. Bow down before the Lord. Almighty God, we pray you graciously to behold this your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed and given into the hands of sinners, and to suffer death upon the cross, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.